Hey everybody, Homeslice Henry here, and in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at a very fun theme team in the Grey League, the Triple Farm Animal theme team. This team features Noct Owl on the lead as a barn owl, Dubwool as the safe switch, which is of course a sheep, and as a closer, the one and only Shiny Miltank, which is a cow. Now this is not a team I'd recommend for climbing, but honestly, it performed way better than I expected. So without further ado, let's hop into the matches and check out the Triple Farm Animal theme team in action in the Grey League. Hopping into the first match, leading Noct Owl into Defense Deoxys. This is definitely a tricky lead because Deoxys can hit the entire team for super effective damage. I stay in with Noct Owl and win the CMP tie on the Shadow Ball. Shadow Ball able to land, and that does massive damage. I'm going to commit the shield on the Noct Owl and then save switch into Dubwool. In comes Dubwool. Dubwool is extremely spammy, able to outpace the Deoxys. Body Slam does force a shield. Deoxys continues to farm up. They bank a Thunderbolt, and in comes Pidgeot. But the opponent has made a mistake. They gave Dubwool an energy lead, and Dubwool with an energy lead is extremely scary. I am almost at Body Slams number 2 and 3 here, firing off the second. Dubwool able to reach a third, and this will just about take out the Pidgeot. Body Slam gets them low. Pidgeot is forced to empty their energy, and that is incredible. Now I can farm down with Miltank. I should be able to leave with a Body Slam, and then Miltank will be able to take down the Deoxys and deny their energy. Opponent thinking about it. They do bring in Deoxys, but this Body Slam will take them out. What do they have in back? It's a Lickitung, and this game is over. I get the notification that the opponent top lefted as the charge move goes through, and that is a good game. Tricky lead in the next match, Noct Owl into Shadow Nidoqueen. I'm going to stay in this lead to start, tank a Poison Fang, hopefully grab a shield with a Sky Attack, and then I can save switch into Dubwool. I tank the Poison Fang, go for the Sky Attack, but my opponent makes a switch into Zweilous. Sky Attack is going to do some solid chip damage onto Zweilous, and now I can bring in Dubwool and let the Body Slam spam begin. Dubwool fires off the Body Slam, gets a shield from Zweilous. They shielded, I'm willing to commit a shield back, and then I think I should be able to overfarm by one double kick and still outpace. I go for the Body Slam, but I miscount, and unfortunately I end up losing CMP. That is quite unfortunate. I'm stuck throwing the Body Slam, so I'm not going to hit any bubbles. This is going to make it do basically no damage and allow me to get one extra double kick to guarantee that I'm going to be able to reach a Body Slam versus the Nidoqueen. Unfortunately, the game does lag quite a bit, but thankfully I am still able to reach my Body Slam, and that's going to do some solid chip damage versus the Nidoqueen. I'm in a bit of a tough spot. I'm going to bring in Noct Owl, again just use it to absorb energy, and then put my faith in Miltank. In comes Miltank, Nidoqueen stays in, and they're going to be getting that guaranteed debuff from Poison Fang. I'm going to let this go. We'll have to see what they have in the back, and it's Unova Stunfisk. I'm very happy that I have Ice Beam here. Ice Beam is going to hit for super effective damage, but with the debuff, I'm definitely in a tough spot here. I farm up to a second Ice Beam. I'm going for a Body Slam bait. Body Slam does get the shield. That's huge. At this point, I think I have to call a Mud Bomb. I let it go. It's just a Mud Bomb. Miltank trying to reach the Ice Beam. They fire off another move. I should be able to shield this and reach the Ice Beam, and I'm able to click it. That's big. This will take down the Yufisk, and then it's a race. Noct Owl versus Nidoqueen. Noct Owl able to outpace and reach the Sky Attack. Sky Attack will be taken care of the Nidoqueen, and we clutch a very close win. Hopping into the next match, leading Noct Owl into Altaria. Fairly neutral lead, so I'm going to stay in here to start. I'm just going to trade Sky Attacks to get some chip damage, and then do what I always do, safe switch into Dubwool. Sky Attack does some nice chip damage, and Altaria, after a little bit of lag, is going to fire back with theirs. I'm going to tank it, bring in Dubwool, and start farming up on energy. In comes Dubwool, charging incredibly quickly. Altaria is going to fire off a move, and I'm going to commit a shield. After I shield this, I should be able to massively overfarm in this matchup. I have the back-to-back Body Slams, firing off the first. This will not KO, but it will get the opponent quite low. I don't want to risk a potential farm down, so I'm just going to fire off Body Slam number 2. That will take down Altaria. Opponent brings in Trevenant. Oh my goodness, they must not know about Payback. Double charging up the Payback. Payback one-shots the Trevenant, and in the back, they have Lantern. Oh my goodness. Double fires off the Body Slam. Opponent not willing to let another move land as they're going to commit the shield on the Body Slam. I'm able to reach one final Body Slam. I'm able to land it, and I'm going to bring in Miltank. And now it's Miltank's job to just continue the Body Slam spam. They fire off the Thunderbolt. Miltank does have some nice bulk to it. Able to tank the Thunderbolt, fire off the Body Slam, and grab the final shield. That's big. At this point, I think I just let this go. They're going to fire off a Surf. Surf is going to get me low, but I'm going to be able to reach one final Body Slam. This will be getting them low, and now it's going to be all up to my Owl. Can Knocked Owl reach a Sky Attack before they reach the back-to-back moves? I'm going to shield up. At this point, they're just going to be going straight Surf. Knocked Owl shields up the Surf and is able to reach the Sky Attack. Sky Attack will be taking out the Lantern, and that is a good game. Hopping into the next match, leading Knocked Owl into Girafarig, some incredibly cool spice from my opponent. I'm going to stay in this lead to start and go straight for the Sky Attack. Girafarig, not the tankiest Pokemon ever, so I'm definitely expecting to grab a shield, which I do, and then I'm going to save switch into Dubwool. I tank any one move here, so I'm going to let it through. It ends up just being a Psychic Fangs. I fire off the Body Slam, and they're going to fire off their next move. I'll be honest, I'm not too familiar with Girafarig counts. I'm pretty sure that could have only been a Psychic Fangs, so I probably didn't need to shield it. I fire off the Body Slam. Body Slam gets them low. Dubwool goes for the farm down, but Girafarig able to reach a last second move. That is quite unfortunate. Psychic Fangs gets me low, and I'm able to farm down. I do have some energy. I'm on very low HP. They have Lantern, and I'm going to be firing off the Payback. Payback will do some solid damage onto the Lantern. Now I can align this Lantern onto my Miltank, and I just have to hope that whatever is in the back, Knocked Owl can beat it. Lantern is going to fire off a Thunderbolt. That does quite a lot of damage, and I'm going to fire back with the Body Slam. Body Slam not going to be lethal from this range, so they are going to be able to let it go. I'm farming up quite a bit, and I'm going to fire off another Body Slam. This will be getting that Lantern dangerously low. Lantern lets it go. In the back, they have Frostlass, and unfortunately, this game is over. Frostlass absolutely destroys both Miltank and my Knocked Owl. So at this point, I just don't have a win con. Frostlass is gonna fire off a move, take out the Miltank, and I concede the match. Nightmare lead in the next match, Knocked Owl into Galarian Stunfisk. My plan here is to save switch into the Miltank and basically just hope that they switch out. They bank a bunch of energy and they do switch out into Politoed. Honestly, that is perfect. I have a massive energy lead, so I should either be able to flip switch here or gain shield advantage. Miltank farms up to 100 energy, firing off the Body Slam. Body Slam does some solid chip damage. Politoed fires off Weather Ball number 2, but Miltank is not stressed about it. Miltank lets it go and just has so much energy stored. Firing off another Body Slam. Body Slam gets a shield from the Politoed. Honestly, that works for me. I'm gonna fire off another Body Slam. Body Slam gets the Politoed low. Politoed continues to overfarm, and that's gonna cost them because now they're forced to give up both shields if they want switch advantage, and they're forced to throw because of the spamminess of Miltank. That is perfectly fine. I'm gonna let Miltank go, farm all the way down with Knocked Owl, and then just hope that two shield Dubwool is going to be able to win me this game. They fire off a last second Weather Ball. I farm down. I'm spamming the switch button. In comes Dubwool. G-Fisk has a lot of energy. They're firing it off. I shield and it's the Earthquake. That's a huge shield. In the back, they have Superior. And honestly, I'm in a pretty decent spot here. I'm up a shield and I'm ahead on energy. So I'm just gonna start spamming out these Body Slams, doing what Dubwool does best. At the last second, I decide to shield up the Frenzy Plant, recognizing that if I do commit the shield there, then at the very least, I can force the Stunfisk to have to Earthquake me. Dubwool continues to farm up, and I'm gonna fire off the Body Slam just before they reach a second Frenzy. This will be taking out Superior, and now back in comes the G-Fisk, but G-Fisk has a lot of work to do here. I try and go for the catch, but they're able to hold on to their energy. That is not the best. They fire off the Rock Slide, and I'm going to hit back hard with the Shadow Ball. That is the nice thing about Shadow Ball on Noct Owl. It gives it great coverage against steel types. My opponent cannot afford to take another move, so they're forced to fire off a Rock Slide. And from here, Dubwool should be able to reach the payback. Payback will be taken down the Stunfisk, and despite the terrible lead, we are still able to get the win. Hopping into the final match, leading Noct Owl into another Altaria. Same game plan as last time. My plan is to trade Sky Attacks and then save switch into the Dubwool. So I farm up and I'm going straight for the Sky Attack right away, hoping that they decide to do the same. Sky Attack lands, but this Altaria player is actually going to overfarm quite a bit. And honestly, that's not what I prefer to have happen in this matchup. I'm still gonna tank the damage and bring in Dubwool. Altaria is gonna fire off a Sky Attack. This time, I do decide to let it go. Dubwool can tank it, but it will do a solid amount of damage. I farm up to the payback, and I'm firing off the Body Slam. Body Slam is going to get the Altaria low, and I'm not taking any chances. I'm going to be firing off a second Body Slam. This will be taking care of the Altaria. We'll have to see what they have in the back. Altaria has been taken out, and it's a Lantern, and that is not great. Lantern doesn't want to get hit with a bigger move, so they fire off the Surf right away. And now, it's Miltank versus Lantern. Can Miltank take down the Lantern? I'm just gonna do what Miltank does best, spam out Body Slams. First one, able to land. Lantern does have quite a bit of energy. Do they go Thunderbolt or do they go Surf? They fire off the Surf. In the back, they have Jellicent, and I'm going to bring in my Noct Owl. Things are honestly looking a bit tough here just because my Noct Owl is incredibly low. I'm gonna fire off the Shadow Ball. Shadow Ball will not KO, but it will do a solid chunk of damage onto the Jellicent. That is quite nice. Jellicent firing off another Bubble Beam. This will not KO. I should be able to reach one final move on the Noct Owl, but at this point, they have a lot of incentive to shield this, because that way, they get to debuff my Miltank. They do commit the shield, they're able to farm down, and that is not great. I bring in Miltank, and they're just gonna go for the debuff spam. Unfortunately, all I have is resisted moves going up against Jellicent. Ice Beam, only single resisted, is not enough to KO, and I'm going to be forced to fire off a Body Slam as well. That is not ideal. Body Slam takes out the Jellicent. Back in comes the Lantern. I still have two shields available on my Miltank, but I am debuffed, and that Lantern still has a decent amount of HP remaining. So I'm just gonna spam out as many Body Slams as possible and hope that I can do enough damage. They commit the shield early. I'm gonna fire off another Body Slam. Unfortunately, I don't think two more Body Slams is going to be enough to KO here, but the timer comes up, and suddenly I see a win con. All I need is to have more HP than my opponent when this timer ends, and I can win this game. I will commit the shield. We should have more HP here, and we do, and the farm animal team clutches a win by timeout. All in all, I had an absolute blast running the triple farm animal theme team. This was my first time using Miltank post-buff, and honestly, I thought it performed pretty well. Dubwool, of course, is an absolute menace on the save switch, and the bulk of Noct Owl just really helped tie the team together. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't. And a special thank you, as always, to our members here on YouTube. The support you guys provide is absolutely incredible. So thank you guys oh so very much. And until next time, I've been Homeslice Henry.